Hey guys, back with a new review. This is, as you can tell, a different type of video. This is the first of hopefully a few, not many, because I want to go all out. But my first review of a Gundam. This is the 1/60th scale. This is... No, go ahead and show it. There he is. The 1/60 big scale, real detail, Force Impulse Gundam from, looks like, Seed Destiny or S Destiny, Gundam Seed. Gonna warn you, I know diddly about Gundams. The last time I watched a Gundam episode, series, whatever, was when I was in middle school. And that was back when Gundam Wing was first released on, I think, Cartoon Network on Toonami. It was a big deal back then. This is the box art for it. It looks really cool. I don't know much about Gundam. I'm guessing that's the pilot for it, him there. That whatever who he is, I don't know. This is made by Bandai, which I think is very nice. You can hear a lot of rattling in there. Turn the size and we've got 1/60 big scale, and you see a separate little components. He does split up into separate pieces, which I thought was kind of cool. Shows his shield extended and closed, and his little accessories, and you know, little details here and there. Other side, I believe, is the exact same. There's that. I think it's just actually reversed. Maybe not exactly the same. Alright, so you get this guy. Gonna open it up real quick, show what all is in there, because there is a lot. It is a model kit, so of course we have the instruction guide. A boatload of little trees of pieces and stuff. Gonna go ahead and pull one of these out for later. But along with all the pieces we have, if I can get to it, a little thing here to show more Gundam figures. Look like they're just action figures. I don't care for them. A little card that's in Japanese. I don't know what that means, so that's kind of pointless. A really small sticker sheet that I use some of the stickers for, not all of them. It includes stickers for his eyes. I'll get to that later. And yeah, so when you're done, you have a box of just things of the sort. Toss that aside. The instruction book is actually kind of cool. On the front, we have the Gundam's front, and on the back, we have the Gundam's back. I did not expect that. Open it up, and it's your basic model guide. It was actually surprisingly easy. You know, it's just, it's all in Japanese, but as long as you can look at pictures and understand things, you're okay. It does show you all the pieces that are there. That's all of them. And it's kind of cool. When you get to the middle of it, I can get to the middle of it. It has, you know, some more poses you can have them in. Shows you how to transform them into their separate components, and it has like a short bio, like here, Gundam stands for Generation Unrestricted Network Drive Assault Module. I did not know that. And I'm guessing the pilot is Shin Asuka. I'm guessing that's right. And it has a color guide, so if you do want to go back and add some detailing, you're going to see on mine, I've done no painting, no detailing at all. I could go back, and this entire part of his shoulder is white. So I could go back, make it black or gray, and add a little detailing. You can do that with paint. And it has the color guide for the kind of paint that would look best for it, which I thought was a really cool little touch with them. But that aside, now, before I do transform, I know I've talked a lot already, I want to give a big thanks to Biker Trash Wolf. If he hadn't bought a gun and started reviewing them, I would have never gotten into them, I guess for the first time. And I also want to thank Protoman V2 for his Gundam reviews. His reviews actually sold me on which one to get. And I asked him personally, you know, which he would recommend, and he suggested this one. And he was correct all the way. This is a very nice model. Very, very big guy. Drop pieces everywhere. You know, when you think a model, you kind of think you can't really touch it, play it. Well, these guys, they're actually built durable enough to be action figure type quality. This is the 1/60 scale. He is rather large. I don't know really where to start, so I guess I'll just cover his little accessories real quick, and then I'll get to the articulation and so on. I have no idea what I'm going to do for an actual basis. His shield itself is actually pretty cool. This is it when it's extended. Now, I don't know the whole premise of the show, why the shield would extend and seal up, I don't know. But it's a kind of cool little detail. We have a toy that you can slide these in, slide that down, and then slide this up into a shield. I thought that was a nice little concept. I'm going to go ahead and pull the shield off. Before I do, the shield pegs into a hole in his arm here. It also has a little grip that fits in his hand, so you can have double support for the shield. But the shield's light up, it's not going to fall out. Going to pull that off. Shield comes right off. Next, get his legs all straight and flat here. I will move to his little jet booster pack that separates just like this. I'm going to lay him down because I don't feel like I'm going to pose real quick. This is actually a kind of cool little pack here. All the wings have their own little movement. These guys can go all the way around. These guys have a little bit of movement here and there. I can get him up a little, a different angle, and then down a little more. It's not a whole lot. When his beam sabers are removed, they fit in right here. Pull those out real quick. You can fold these guys down, but this is my one complaint. When I got this guy and civiled him, this one actually snapped a little clip, and I have no idea how. I did it exactly how I did the other one. Some glue does seem to have fixed it, but I'm not going to do too much with it. I like leaving it just in a, you know, stable position and leave it. But those guys do fold down entirely like this one does. So maybe I was a little too rough with it. I don't really know. But still, very cool little accessory. And I've seen pictures where I think another model kit, a ship can dock and fly this around. I don't know if that's certain or not, so don't quote me on that. But it is a possibility. Now, I mentioned his little beam sabers, lightsabers, whatever you want to call them. These guys here, they come with two of these, and they just peg right in the top, just like that. Pretty cool little accessory. I'll show more of those in a bit. Get to what I think is a nice little thing, is gun. That is a massive gun right there. The little flash on the top does move. It's not, you know, illuminated. It's not see-through, translucent, whichever. It's just a plain old white. This does swivel around this, so you can get some kind of little movement with it. It fits in his hand really nice and snug. When you open his hand up, you stand here for a minute, will you, Wilbur? He has this little tab that flips out. Try from the back where I'm not actually pointing the camera. Little tab right there that flips inside the gun, and it can go to the other side. So you can have his gun in either hand, which is kind of cool. If you don't want to have the gun displayed in his hand, there's a little tab on the back, a little slot in his rear. Plug his rear up with the gun, and I know that sounds really dirty. Just bear with me here. And he can hold his gun like that and support it, so he doesn't have to use it. Back to his little beam saber. It has a similar mechanism inside there. That little tab right there, can't kind of show it because it's kind of tiny, but flips out to have another little tab. And just like the gun, there is the little slots in his hands right there. Sword just fits right in his hand, and I've only removed one of the swords from its little tree. And it fits in his hand just like that, which I think is kind of cool. I love swords, so. But he actually stays posed with his gun in his hand. That aside. And his last accessories, fold his arm up. Each side of his waist has these little pockets. Flip them down, and inside you will find, and I forgot the technical name for them, but it's like a flip-out razor anti-armor knife or something of that. Little dinky knife. This is all collapsed. It flips out into this, which is actually kind of cool, you know. It just fits his hand like the sword, everything does. There's no tab for it. It just fits right in, wrap his fingers around it, and he's good. On the box, it shows a detail where you can paint this more show accurate, to where just the little tip is white, and the rest is kind of more of a steel or a black. May do that eventually, I'm not entirely sure, but it's a cool accessory. Just fold it back up, open the pocket, and it just fits right back in, and it locks in place pretty well, just like that. Alright, now, take his gun back off. I mentioned his hands, where it can hold the gun. I wasn't kidding. So this model, and I actually sent a text to like 3 or 4 friends who knew I was making this, and I was like, his hands are ball jointed! That's right. His hands, each little finger, shows a little better there, is ball jointed. They're all separate. There's one little knuckle joint here. You fall all the way around. Each one is its own separate joint, which at the time was a bit annoying to make because they're almost all exactly the same, I believe. They all look exactly alike. So you have a hand that's open, exposed, and you are going through and attaching fingers that look just alike. It got kind of repetitive, but still kind of fun. Fingers are ball jointed. His elbow has a joint here. I was thinking a double joint, but it's just one joint. My camera's losing focus. Maybe it's my fault. You can't do this. His shoulders have full movement all the way around. And they even have movement out like this. You can fold it in. These rotate. His head has full articulation all the way around. It can look down. It can look up. It's on its own ball joint. His waist can rotate. It probably could go further if you really tried, but I'm not going to. It's just shimmy, shimmy, shimmy type thing. His legs, once you move the little skirts up, he has full hip movement. He has a double joint in his knee. His ankle, the toe, can move just like this. That's really about it, but still, it's kind of cool. Has a little swivel action, a little bit, but is limited by his ankle. I think that's really about it. I mean, this guy has really good posability, really good movement. It's hard to believe that it's a model kit that you build yourself with no glue. You heard me right. I'm still shocked about that. Very, very nice, but we're not done yet. I'm going to take this apart. Just give it a nice little tug. I think I tugged too hard. Let me not tug as much next time. There we go. Never did that before. The legs, just kind of set them aside. And get them kind of propped up here. I want to point his head, and I cannot find my little flashlight I use. But his head, you can either have it where there are stickers going in his eyes. I decided not to do that. But this is kind of hard to show. The piece is really in there. This little tab in the back here comes off to expose the light piping effect, which I don't know if I have any lights nearby that can do it, but he has light piping in his eyes. I'm not sure that would have changed if I put the stickers in, so I left them out. This piece just pops right back on. Now reach inside of his back area, slide this down, that aside, and here is his core fighter. Just this little piece here, everything unfolds, clicks in place, fold the wings out, fold the tail fins up. Before you do, his jetpack booster pack plugs in two holes in his shoulders, one on the middle of the core fighter. Just kind of flip that up or down, and it makes it solid, just like that, which I think is kind of cool. Flip the tail fins up, and there's your core fighter, a nice little ship. You can actually see the pilot inside. Really cool little detailing. I like things that can transform. I really do. Gets me all giddy. Now, he has two more little transformations. I don't know the purpose of them. I honestly don't. I think they both look kind of stupid. But we're going to go with it anyway. Extend his shoulders outwards. So he's ready for a big hug. Fold his arms. Fold them up. Fold them up. So he's in a zombie... It's like a zombie. I like it. I love zombies, so hey, it's a mode that's kind of growing on me. I fold his fingers in, get him so he's, you know, trying to block a sneeze, pretty much. And get his hand like this. You're going to get his gun, fold the little clip out, and then peg it into his hand. Get the gun in his hand, fold his arm like this, and then I can't get it to fit with the handle in, so I just take the handle out. Pop his shield on, and that's one of his modes. He slides around on his shield and shoots terrorists. I don't know. I know it's unstable. It doesn't balance very well. It just topples over, so I don't like that mode. His legs also have their own little thing. Flip the skirts up. Folds the knee at his double joint so that the leg looks like this compared to that. If I can show it, there you go. And then closes little feetsums. And I think that's it. So, I don't know, maybe you could, I don't know, but it's there, it's mentioned in the instructions, so it must be important. I've never watched the show, so I don't know anything about all that little hoopla stuff. Gonna reassemble him though, because I think it's kind of cool. Fold everything back in. You know, I'm going to try this. I'm not going to move from this spot. I'm too lazy. Fold everything back in. Fold the wings down. Fold those down. Put them aside. Take his legs. Fold everything down. Fold his feet out. Fold the skirts down. I love zooming out. Take the core fighter. It plugs right into the back. You could have it go into the top torso first, but I think it really matters. So that just fits in there. Get him. Go ahead and get the big boy here. Take out the shield. Fold his arms. Fold his arms. Lock the shoulders in. Or slide. Not really locking. It's more of a sliding action. One problem I have, his arm comes off a lot. It's just from movement. I imagine it's not supposed to, but it does. It's not really annoying because I have mine post and, you know, I don't really move him. But when you work the arm enough, it just works its way out. Only downside that I can really see with it, but I'm not going to complain because I like it. So you got everything all set up here. Maybe you should start with the core fighter going into his shoulders. I don't know. All right, so he's assembled. You know, he looks very nice. You can get him in a lot of different different poses. He's very sturdy. His feet are nice and big. You can get him just, I think, almost in any kind of pose you could imagine. I mean, he kind of leans a little bit, but if you get his feet positioned right, he will look pretty cool. He holds, not for very long, probably. When you do assemble his jetpack on, I'm just getting everything set back up to put his gear back on him. It is kind of cool, though, that, you know, he has this little grip on his shield, and it still pegs into his arm, so it gives the illusion that he really is holding his shield, even though we know the truth that he can't get a grip on it to save his life. I think that's definitely an interesting little thing. And I again, love how the shield just extends and locks in place and fold those out. I just think that adds so much of a look to him. It improves things so much. Get him up again. Alright, now spin him around. Here's that little cover on the core fighter. Flip it up or down. It's up this time. So you expose the hole. Get him standing real quick. Make sure this little peg in the middle is up. It'll fit a lot easier. And they simply just plug into each other. You know, there's not really anything complicated about it. And it fits, I think, pretty snugly. Sometimes I have to kind of realign things because it'll tend to slide off. But I think it looks very nice on him. I don't have his little beam sabers in the top, but you get the idea. The backpack does make him a little bit back heavy, just a little bit, so you have to compensate slightly. But it's definitely not enough where you really notice it. Overall, I think he's a really nice little model kit. It sounds bad. It took me a good maybe 8 hours to assemble him, including breaks. But I've never had as much fun playing with a toy than I did building this guy. I would highly recommend, you know, honestly, to anybody to pick up a Gundam. This is the 160 scale, so I think this is definitely one of the harder ones. But it's definitely a good starting off point. There are smaller ones. I think it's like 144 and 1100. I would definitely recommend a Gundam to somebody. You can go back. I mentioned, you know, the whole paint detailing thing. You can get a little model pen and go through all these little seams and add black lining to make it look like it's actual paneling on an actual robot that's about to kill everybody in sight. You can do that, and I think it would make improve the thing just even more. But that's it, guys. I'm done. I hope you enjoyed the review a little bit. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.